Hello, and welcome to this quick video where I will walk you through how to configure a virtual lab. My name is Rick Vanover. I've been at Veeam for several years, and this is one of the capabilities that I really like about the Veeam data platform. This is something that you can use for analytics, for recovery verification, and more. I want to show it to you from start to finish so that you know how you can use this capability to solve some business problems. Let's jump into the lab and take a look. Okay, so what I'm looking at is Veeam Backup and Replication. Now, this particular capability is not included in the Community Edition, so you would need to download a full trial to use this. So I want to introduce you to a Sure Backup job. So a Sure Backup job is how this was created. Basically, it was a way to ensure what we back up is indeed recoverable. So how do you get there? Well, let's go into the Backup Infrastructure section of Veeam Backup and Replication. So Sure Backup is created by combining really two important constructs. The first is what we call an application group, and the second is a virtual lab. And the good thing about the user interface here is that we have these narratives that describe to you exactly what they are. And additionally, you can go to helpcenter.veeam.com and you can read the full documentation on this part of the product as well. Now, a Sure Backup job, like I said, combines an application group and a virtual lab to run, to do things like recovery verification, additional malware scans, and more. So let me show you this one that I've created here. So this data lab or application group has been created. We give it a name, and you could be dynamic with it. You could have this as a starter for all types of use cases, or you could build them specifically for an application that you want this use case ready for. Now, I have a Linux system in here that I have identified. And one thing I'll highlight is when you add these, you can add them from what is backed up. You can add them from what you have as a replica. And you also can add them in from storage snapshots. So if you have a Veeam integrated storage system, you can add it from the storage snapshot. So that means you don't have to use your backup or your replication infrastructure. You can use those other resources as well. And one of the other things I'll highlight is for this system that we've put in here, we could put in some different roles, like maybe it's a SQL server or maybe it runs a web service, you know. So this will tell me to look for certain ports like 1433 or 80 and things like that. The other thing you can do is specify how much memory is going to be allocated to this data lab or virtual lab. Now, I have this set to 100%, but keep in mind, sometimes you might want to do this on these monster applications that might have several gigabytes of memory provisioned in the production use case when it is serving applications for people and users and things like that. But in the data lab, it might not have that type of need. So you could scale it down to 50, for example, something like that. And the other thing that we'll do when we run the data lab in the isolated environment is take a look to see that the VM heartbeat is present, the response to network pings, and also, if it's Windows, disable that firewall. So pretty cool stuff there. And you also can add some additional test scripts and credentials to run them. So a lot of flexibility. And that's it. Now, the other half of that is the virtual lab. So this is a networking configuration. So the whole idea of the virtual lab is that it runs in an isolated environment from a network perspective. You might remember those three options I said from the backup, from the replica, from the storage snapshot. So from a storage standpoint, it runs there. It uses a production host CPU and memory, but the networking right here is where you configure that. Now this depends a lot on what you're using. So I'm gonna walk you through my environment and show you what a few of the options would look like. So the first thing I've done is identify what host I'm gonna run this in and where it's gonna sit in the environment. I think it's also rather important that we make sure that when you run a virtual lab, there's a designated place for it. So I have a resource pool within a folder, so it's somewhat self-documenting by its location of what it is and how it's going to behave in the environment. Now, I did say that the data lab or the virtual lab will run from the storage options I identified earlier, but that's a read-only selection. And what I mean by that is, in the course of running a virtual machine, there is a write. Now, by default, those will be stored in the vPower NFS cache on the, basically on the C drive of the Veeam server. You can configure that to go elsewhere, but if you wanted to, for more performance, you could have the writes go to a data store. So I could pick my production data store. And again, these are temporary writes. They're not going to interfere with the production virtual machines. You don't have to do this option, but if you wanted higher performance for your writes, you could do that. One of the notions of a virtual lab is this notion of a proxy appliance. So this is the configuration here that does the bulk of the work from the networking perspective. So one of the things I'll highlight right here is that if we have a proxy appliance in the lab, now when I say appliance, this is a virtual machine that's running the prescribed network connection that we're setting right here. So it's not a piece of hardware. It's a very small virtual machine. In fact, I don't even think it has a virtual machine hard drive. It actually boots to a configuration with a minimal amount of networking and memory assigned to it. So in here, in the configuration option, I have the IPv4, and in this environment, I'm not using IPv6. I do have DHCP in this environment, but if I didn't, I could configure the IPs of that proxy. And then if I needed to get to the internet, first of all, I can allow it. And then if I needed a proxy, I could configure it. So really important use case here. If you have a system that hasn't had updates in a long time, in the virtual lab may be a good place to try that. And then you can ensure that that system will process those upgrades and updates well, so that when you do it in production, you don't have any surprises. There's your first use case. Now the networking. Now, if you're in a small environment without distributed switches and stuff, this option is going to be the way to go. But you have the most configuration options with advanced multi-host right here. So I do have a distributed virtual switch in this environment, so that's the option I'm going to take. And here, once it takes a look at the environment, you can go through and configure the different networks, identify what is the production network, and then determine what is your isolated network. And so right here, the isolated network is what I'm calling the virtual lab, data lab VMs, and my production network was resolved to be the one that we call lab VMs. You also could get into the specific configuration around the IP and the masquerade IP. So I myself am not an expert in the networking space, but I do know that the masquerade IP, by just basically having this different octet right here, you will have the same behavior inside of the isolated environment that the virtual machines are expecting from a networking space, but how you get to it on the production network, that through the masquerade IP makes it really easy for you. And then the other thing you could do is some optional static mapping if you wanted to like have a direct access to something that you were going to regularly use in the virtual lab, you could define that here. And really, that's it. Basically, all of those options, you will define the networking here in the virtual lab, and then the application group above will determine what VMs will be set. And then, once you're done with this, you can put these two together to make this sure backup job. So what's happening right here is we're actually sending that configuration back out to the virtual environment so that this virtual lab will be ready to go. And I did make a few changes, but basically it rebuilds it every time. I'd like to call this network proxy appliance somewhat ephemeral because it does not run at all times. It only runs when the sure backup job is running. And so that all completed successfully. So I'm going to end right back where I started with this sure backup job. So now this job that I have here will make a little bit more sense because it will select the two that we've defined. And we only have two in this environment, but it's a good place to start. And my advice to you is start simple. Start with one or two really simple VMs, make an application group, get the networking right, and get familiar with the functionality and build on it. And you would just select which virtual lab, select which application group. You'll see that these ones that I had were right here, and I did have that memory scoped down to 50%. And this is a super important option. If you have an analytics use case, you can run the Sure Backup job after it's done indefinitely. And the thought here is if you intentionally wanted to do things like test Windows updates or test Linux updates or test an application upgrade, you have the ability to do that safely in here. You could link it specifically to different backup jobs, for example. I have a number of different backup jobs, but if I wanted something maybe that's on a tier two type of storage, by default, it's going to go from the most recent restore point, if not. And probably my favorite option right here, and it's intentional why this is on here, already selected, is the malware scan. So the data lab or the virtual lab is an outstanding mechanism if you wanted to scan what you've backed up to make sure it's free from any malware threats, especially if your security platform maybe identified something as suspicious. Take what you have under management with Veeam as a backup, run it in this virtual lab and do this scan. This is really, really powerful. This scan will use a number of the built-in native tools, such as Windows Defender, Symantec, Kaspersky, ESET, and others. You can even add into the XML file more. But you can also ensure that this is done with the absolute latest definitions. So super, super powerful option. Now you could run a Sure Backup job on demand with a schedule, or much like other best practices, you could run it right after whatever is backed up. So if example 15 had this application group or parts of it that I really cared about, I could immediately run this Sure Backup job in Virtual Lab right after the backup is taken. So really, really powerful options here. And you can save that schedule, and there it is right there. So just like that, the Virtual Lab is one of the most powerful capabilities of the Veeam data platform. It's central to so many other things, including the orchestrator, the ability to verify recovery, malware scans, and more. If you like what you see, go over to Veeam.com and you can download a trial right away and have this in your hands and find a way to make the Virtual Lab work for you.